Pray tell, help us.
Sure.
How about somebody who's not...
Good job.
...weighed down? Okay, good. I was afraid it wasn't available. 800. Well, we have it. Oh, he's still talking to me. Yeah, we're done. There he is. Dragging around your plate armor. I'll take that. Which one's this? Potion absorption. This is his helm, I think. Yeah, he was holding on to these darts and things. Splint mail, maybe we can sell. Put that in there. What about his swords? Don't tell us we left that. Did we... Did we leave his swords? That would not be cool.
Alright.
We gotta return. She won't buy this stuff.
All right.
I'm afraid we
must.
Why me? We must return right away. I'm still slowed. Wait a second. Because I have this. Oh, screw this. Well, he can carry it. Yeah, we have his wakizashi and the other sword. just in case. That's all we have without dipping into potions.
I don't want to talk. Sure. All right.
Okay, was this the site of the battle here? I must have got mixed up with all this. Thank you. We'll be on our way. So before we leave and get in a random encounter. I think he was using Haverwer plus one? This is a short sword. Is it? Yeah. That's a long sword. He's good at, two weapon style, two-handed sword, which I guess would, yeah, would include longsword, but not short sword. It's one-handed. Well, he's dual wielding, but he has two weapon style. I'm pretty sure these are the swords he had. Oh, where's that helmet? Here we go. Let's get back.
Sure.
This is quite the disaster here. We need to rest up. Do we have anything to identify? We know what that is. Oh, not identified. Arrow of ice. This arrow is magically enhanced so as to burst into a rolling ball of ice and cold when fired. When the arrow strikes its victim, a shock of cold will travel through its body, both burning and numbing to the very core. Yeah, that was pretty bad. 1d6 and an extra 1d6 cold damage. It was pretty devastating against us, that's for sure. Faerûn would just hold on to it, because she is holding on to that stuff. Arrow plus one. What is this again? Dart of wounding. And regular dart. Alright. You can sell the splint mail. Oh, I wonder if we have the splint mail that I dropped? Where did I drop that? Back over here somewhere, right? Or on the way out? I'll probably see it pop up here in the quick weapon. We can sell that. Resting time. Yeah, Peldvale is... Well, it wasn't bad until we came across those guys. That's pretty devastating. Hmm. You're not seeing it. Unless I dropped it in here. She's selling any cures.
Why me?
She is. Elixir of health. Cures poison and disease and heals 10 hit points. How much do these do? 9 hit points. These are expensive though. Critical. The Cure Critical Wound spell is a very potent version of the Cure Light Wound spell. The priest lays her hands upon a creature and heals 27 points of damage from wounds or other injuries. The spell does not affect creatures without corporeal bodies, those of extraplanar origin, or those not living. Here we want to get one of these just in case. These damn books. She can't even... Yeah, she can't put that in her quiver. Okay. It topped her off, that's what it did. Can't put that in anything. Oh, we need some bullets, don't we? Soon. Okay.
And packing steel. Why me?
Right, let's go rest. Sell her a few things. I wonder if I could see that.
Sure.
We don't need to identify anything. We need to distribute our potions of healing. Split mail only gets us 16. Maybe I should use this thing. Wand of Monster Summoning. I don't suppose he has bullets. He does. Okay. I must be full. Alright. I've already read the books for posterity. So I'm gonna have to get rid of them. He won't buy them.
Yes?
I'm just gonna drop them. I know from your perspective, you guys haven't seen me read all of them. Wait. But, I have. Which one's this? Now we have some more room.
Fine.
So, he's got 4. I'm gonna have him have 4 as well, meaning Minsk. Dining here has 2. I have 3. 2 and 3. Minsk seems to need them more, so let him have 6 on hand, and Kagan would have 5. All right, now we rest.
A simple matter.
Much better. Yeah, let's get out of here.
Sure.
Back to
you
it.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Why me?
If it wasn't for that sleep spell, we would have been a lot more messed up than we were.
All right.
Back to Peldvale. We'll explore this place or die trying. All right, the cave bear wants to fight us. All right. Who are we to deny it?
Arras, give us victory!
No pelt. No.
This group shows promise. Exceptional.
Exceptional.
Hello?
We had to use our healing spells so early, but...
Go pester someone else! Why me?
Alright, let's go. Continue on. Minsk can carry that. Minsk can carry quite a lot. Alright, at least we can't be hit by lightning. We if these guys are guarding anything. We're just hanging out here. Wild dogs. Much easier than what we were fighting. Oh, wait. We got here. Willie, Sam, and Rob. Were they under attack by the wild dogs? Well, unless they're being attacked by someone else, they're okay.
Go for the eyes! Brask!
Give
for the eyes, boo! Go for the eyes! Brask!
My blade will cut you down to size!
You guys are right over here? Willie? Oh, these bears? I actually just noticed them.
Yes, the, a tab. Another ale, young miss. I'll be sure to have your funds ready.
What are you talking about? Lake Poet Willie. You came to listen to us poets? Well, do sit down and enjoy the recital. Ah, I know a song which will be just to your taste. Who is the I'm not singing this. Who is the happy warrior? Who is he that every man in arms should wish to be? It is a generous spirit who, when bought, among the tasks of real life hath wrought. Upon the plan that pleased his boyish thought, whose high endeavors are an inward light, that makes the path before him always bright. Who, with a natural instinct to discern what knowledge can perform, is diligent to learn, abides by this resolve, and does not stop there.
Yes, the, a tab. Another ale, young miss. I'll be sure to have your funds ready.
It's like they think they're at a bar. To my most noble audience, I shall recite my latest song called A Dungeon. And this place our forefathers made for man. This is the process of our love and wisdom. To each poor brother who offends against us, most innocent perhaps, and what if guilty? And Rob?
Yes, the, a tab. Another ale, young miss. I'll be sure to have your funds ready.
Such inspiring surroundings. Lakes, sun, skies. Makes me wish to recite poetry. Mine own. I wrote this one when I saw a cavern. Enter this cavern, stranger. The ascent is long and steep and toilsome. Here a while. Okay, you people haven't finished your... Oh, it continues. Thou mayest repose here from the noontide heat, or canopied by this arched rock that strikes a grateful coolness, clasping its rough arms. Round the rude portal the old ivy hangs.
'Tis surprising what one can learn at a simple country fair,
Its dark green branches down, and the wild bees, o'er its gray blossoms murmuring ceaseless, make most pleasant melody. No common spot receives thee, for the power who prompts the song loves this secluded haunt. The tide below scarce sends the sound of waters to thine ear, and this high-hanging forest of the wind varies its many hues. Gaze, stranger, here. How long does this go on for? And let thy softened heart intensely feel how good, how lovely, nature went from hence, departing to the city's crowded streets. Thy sickening eye at every step revolts from scenes of vice and wretchedness. Reflect that man creates the evil he endures.
I've traveled the length and breadth of Faerûn, and there's always something new.
Very, very inspired piece.
Awfully familiar with that pointer, aren't you? And after only one drink, too.
Guys are drinking out here. Sam? So there's more to these poems, okay. Is this the only cure, merciful God? Each pore and natural outlet shriveled up. By ignorance and parching poverty, his energies roll back upon his heart and stagnate and corrupt, till changed to poison, they break out on him like a loathsome plague spot. Then we call in our pampered mountebanks, and this is their best cure. Uncomforted, in friendless solitude, groaning in tears, and savage faces, at the clanking hour, seen through the steams and vapor of his dungeon by the damp's dismal twilight. So he lies, circled with evil, till his very soul unmolds its existence, unmolds its essence, hopelessly formed by sights of ever more deformity. With other ministrations thou, O nature, healest thy wandering and distempered child, thou pourest on him thy soft influences, thy sunny hues, fair forms, and breathing sweets, thy melodies of woods and winds and waters, till he relent and can no more endure. To be a jarring and dissonant thing, amid this general dance and minstrelsy, but bursting into tears, wins back his way, his angry spirit healed and harmonized by the benignant touch, not a word, benignant touch of love and beauty.
'Tis surprising what one can learn at a simple country fair, hmm?
Why, I think that you should ask Robin Willie to recite some of their poetry. Alright, I already did. We'll continue with Willie. But makes his moral being his prime care, who, doomed to go in company with pain and fear and bloodshed, miserable train, turns his necessity to glorious pain, in face of these doth exercise a power which is our human nature's highest dower, controls them and subdues, transmutes, bereaves of their bad influence and their good receives, by objects which might force the soul to abate her feeling, rendered more compassionate. I don't know really what he's talking about with this. Is placable because occasions arise so often that demand such sacrifice, more skillful in self-knowledge, even more pure, as tempted more able to endure, as more exposed to suffering and distress, thence also more alive to tenderness. 'Tis he whose law is reason, who depends upon that law, as on the best of friends, whence in a state where men are tempted still, too evil for a guard against worst ill. And what in quality or an act is best, doth send them seldom on a right foundation rest. He labors good on good to fix, and owes to virtue every triumph that he knows, who, if he rise to station of command, rises by open means, and there will stand on honorable terms, or else retire, and in himself possess his own desire, who comprehends his trust, and to the same keeps faithful with a singleness of aim. Brother. And therefore does not stoop, nor lie in wait, for wealth or honors, or for worldly state, whom they must follow, on whose head must fall, like showers of manna, if they come at all, whose powers shed round him in the common strife, or mild concerns of ordinary life, a constant influence, a peculiar grace, but who, if he be called upon to face some awful moment by which to which heaven has joined great issues, good or bad, for humankind, is happy as a lover and attired with sudden brightness like a man inspired, and through the heat of conflict keeps the law in calmness made, and sees what he foresaw, or if an unexpected call succeed, come when it will, is equal to the need. He who, though thus endured, is with a sense and faculty for storm and turbulence, is yet a soul whose master bias leans to home-felt pleasures and gentle scenes. Are we about wrapping up here? Oh, sweet images, which, wheresoe'er he be, are at his heart in such fidelity. It is his darling passion to approve, more brave for this, that he hath much to love. 'Tis finally the man who lifted high, conspicuous object in a nation's eye, or left unthought of in obscurity, who, with a toward or untoward lot, prosperous or averse to his wish or not, plays in the many games of life, that one...
'Tis surprising what one can learn at a simple country fair, hmm?
I'm not going to continue much further. Two more, how about? Where what he most doth value must be one whom neither shape of danger can dismay, nor thought of tender happiness betray, who, not content that former worth stand fast, looks forward, persevering to the last. From well to better, daily self-surpassed, who, whether praise of him, must walk the earth, forever into noble deeds give birth, or he must fall, to sleep without his fame, and leave a dead, unprofitable name. I think we're done. Finds comfort in himself and in his cause, and while the mortal mist is gathering, draws his breath in confidence of heaven's applause. This is the happy warrior, this is he, that every man in arms should wish to be. Why, you are quite a lover of poetry, my good woman. Your company would surely benefit from carrying a decent harp around. We have a little competition among the three of us. We are all ruminating on a ballad about that brave fellow who is fighting bandits along the Sword Coast. Okay.
I have a story for every man, woman, and child in Faerûn. However, copyright laws forbid me the telling.
Okay. That was interesting. Still have a lot to explore. I'm going to call it an episode here on these poems. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode when we explore some more of Peldvale. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.